So we're out here with the team today. They are doing pre and post construction CCTV inspections on storm drains that are through this new construction building that's going on here to the south of us. And on the plans, they have a maintenance hatch that's somewhere in this grass area. And the way we identify that is to pull out one of these metal detectors and look for metal. And it works on basically a tone. There's a gauge on it as well, but you give her around for tone. And we picked up a piece of rebar earlier, reburied it, but you can hear it in here. So somewhere in this grass area, we've got a maintenance hatch that's been buried over, probably rarely accessed over the last 10 or 20 years, and the grass has grown in here. It doesn't look like this was a kept lawn for quite a period of time. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna sweep this sort of on a grid pattern, and hopefully we can discover it and uncover it, because we'll need to have the team come over and then drop the camera and the flushing system in, flush that pipe out, and do a camera inspection of that pipe. So our first goal is to find this particular access point. So according to the drawings, they have used a tree as one of the markers. So they are saying it's just to the northeast side of the tree. It's not a catch basin, so it's not within the previously paved area. Now, all we can tell is that it lines up in the following direction, which is where the other end of the pipe is. A lot of construction debris. This is a bit of a patient game. That's still picking up the vents. So we're not having success with this metal detector, so we're gonna ramp it up quite significantly. So what we're going to propose is bringing in an EM-61, which is just a fancy way of saying it's a really powerful metal detector. And we can run it over here and it'll give us the anomalies. We can flag them all, and then we can scrape the soil and the grass back, and we can see whether or not we found the manhole that we're missing. This device with this thicket, we've picked up some caps, some rebar, a couple of pieces of wire, but we're not picking up the large system. So it has to be in here somewhere, so that probably means it's quite a bit deeper than we're expecting, and this device doesn't have the depth capability. So we're gonna move in with an EM-61 here in the coming days.